day this way, BB. Today would be a very special day if your mommy hadn't. You're not born yet. But the more candles, the merrier, right? Soon it'll be time for you to come out into the real world. I promise. And then, we can have a real party. Well, happy birthday.
Constant timefall in this region for a while now. As a result, everything you've built for us out here has been completely destroyed. The good news is, we managed to recover all cargo stored on site and transferred it to the capital Nod City Distro Center. As for the not-so-good news, Cairo printers are currently unusable due to the network instability. Given the circumstances, you might want to consider turning to your fellow porters for assistance. But I'll leave that up to you, Sam. I'm sure you'll come through for us. You always do.
Yeah. Thank you. Someone's happy.
Thank you.
Yes, you did it, Sam! Oh, I could kiss you, you sweet son of a bitch! I thought it was all over.
You're back. It must have been one hell of a journey, especially on your own. But now the whole team is together again.
The whole team? Die Hardman too?
Too much traveling to and from beaches in such a short span. Chiral matter contaminated her cells, effectively causing jet lag on a molecular level. Because of that, her homeostatic mechanisms were shaken. Don't worry, she's not in any danger, but she needs some rest.
So where's the director?
He's being looked after in another room. Bridges personnel found him lying outside the isolation ward. Similar to when you came back from Cliff's Beach. Even after decontamination, she needed more and more time to recover.
Sam, you made it.
Hungry?
Thanks. Looks like you need me after all. Who'd have thought? Anyway, clock's ticking. Am I right? Sam's here. The Great Deliverer. The only one who can reach Amelie's Beach.
You're in no condition to do this. It's not fair to you, or Sam.
In my own search for Amelie's Beach, I have come to realize something extraordinary. If beaches were likened to a multiverse, hers would appear to exist on a higher plane than ours. I can walk the beaches of others, but hers is beyond my reach. It's invisible, inaccessible, even to fragile, I fear. Imagine it as a circulatory system, if you will. Each of our beaches is a single capillary, but Amelie's Beach is the heart that pumps blood to the rest of us. Capillaries are subordinate to the greater whole. A whole governed by the heart, which gives direction, which dictates flow, which dictates everything, controls everything. Don't you see? She is in control. You may be able to travel against the flow and reach her, but having done so, if she does not wish to let you go, if she wishes to keep you, she can.
Fragile and Die Hardman broke free from her beach, didn't they?
I don't think it was any different from what happened to you. I didn't get out because I wanted to. I was forced out, repatriated, if you will, by her.
Forced out? Why?
This is only a theory, but she wants you to go to her. That's her final wish, don't you think?
So that's it, huh? Amelie's the EE, and this is her endgame. Just so we're clear, if I want to stop the last stranding and come back in one piece, I need to go to her beach and talk her out of it. That about right?
Correct. As cliche as it sounds, you're our only hope. Though quite frankly, I doubt even you can change her mind.
If you can't make her see reason, you'll have to kill her. And if you kill her,
you'll save the world, but you'll be stranded outside of it. Forever.
Might as well make it official then. You ready to deliver the package? I'll talk to her. Maybe she'll listen. But with the shape the world's in, it'll only be delaying the inevitable. Still, if it buys us time to try and build something better, a new lease on life, at least for a little bit. Well, I can think of one woman who made the most of a chance like that. Nothing lasts forever, not even the world. But we gotta keep it going as long as we can, right? Patch the holes, change the parts, all that. So we can say we had a good run, that we lived.
Thought you didn't like having to handle things with care.
Because it was hard enough keeping my own shit together. Back when we met at the cave, the only thing I cared about was making it to the next sunrise. Sure as hell didn't care about America or the future. I was living a lie, hung up on past regrets. I was broken. But somewhere along the way, I started changing. Started meeting people that made me think that maybe it wasn't all bad. People that put their faith in tomorrow, and in me. That kept the lights on, and waited for hope to arrive. So I gotta deliver, for their sake.
Even if it means you never come back?
Fucked if I do, fucked if I don't. Right. Take care of Lou.
I will.
Couldn't find a working still mother east of Port Knot City. Kid's done enough. No more.
All right. I'll do my best to nurse our little one back to health.
Concentrate. Help me look for Emily. Reach for her, Sam. Feel her. I know you love her. You love her!
abandoned bridges falling down. Falling down. Falling down. London bridges falling down. My fair lady.
The last stranding has already begun.
Amelie?
You're too late. What took you so long?
Your voice.
You still don't know who I am, do you?
Who are you?
Sam. I knew you'd come back. Sam.
I'll be waiting for you on the beach. I've been waiting for you, right here, ever since. You were supposed to stop me. Stop all of this.
Bridget?
Yes. It's me, Sam.
Where's Amelie?
Where she's always been. Nowhere. My daughter, Samantha America Strand, doesn't exist.
Amelie doesn't exist?
Not in your world. I'm sorry, Sam. To wear a mask for so long. Amelie and Bridget are both a part of me.
What's this supposed to mean?
Quiet, and I'll tell you. There is no time for questions. Listen. Just listen. Do you understand, Sam? Amelie and Bridget, those are just names. What I am is an extinction entity. So, knowing what you know now, you have two choices.
I was getting shot, one of them.
You wouldn't come back if it happened here, you know. You'd be straight on to the afterlife. But no. It's not one of them. Killing you would be a terrible mistake. I know that better than anyone. The last stranding has already begun. A seam has formed from my beach and the beaches of every soul in America. And soon it will be inundated by a vast surge of antimatter starting here. In a flash, this world will be no more. Consumed by an explosion. A big bang. So, that brings us to your first choice. Do nothing. Stay here with me and bear witness to the very end.
Just watch it burn.
Together. With me. Until the last flame winks out. Doesn't sound so bad, does it? It's not like the world has long left anyway. Then there's the second choice. In expanding the network, you brought people and their beaches together, integrating them into a greater whole. Like this Khipu. But in doing so, you also bound them to my beach. The very beach where I opened the gates to the other side. You can't stop what's coming. But if you cut me and my beach loose, perhaps you can stop it from spreading. You might just prevent the last stranding. And mankind will live to die another day.
And it doesn't have to end here.
But it does. The beach is doomed no matter what. One look ought to tell you that. Which is why we must sever our connection.
That'll be it. The end of the Death Stranding.
You can't stop the inevitable. The sixth extinction will happen either today or tomorrow. You can either end it with dignity, quick, clean, and in a flash, or you can struggle in vain, knowing full well what's waiting come the finish. Those are your choices. You kept it all this time. Perhaps you still have a chance to stop this nightmare. You brought the world together. You have the right to decide. Pull the rope or cut the noose. But whatever you do, don't hesitate. I'm ready, Sam Strand. Make your choice.
Wait. I don't know what to do.
Sure you do. After everything, how could you not?
I'm here for you. Always. Like you were for me.